we need to discuss artificial discs because they're a big and popular topic right now, and we have to discuss what they are, what they do and what they don't do, and some of the problems associated with artificial discs. In general, I think artificial discs work well for the neck or for the cervical spine, but I'm not a big fan of them for the lumbar spine for a number of different reasons. The first thing you have to understand is how these discs are implanted. You have to make an incision in the belly, move down through the intestines, move away the aorta and the vena cava to get to the front of the disc to implant these. Now, to understand why they don't work as well as a regular disc is pretty easy to understand. A regular disc is a shock absorber. It absorbs impact, and it'll have some constraint on motion so that it won't translate much. It acts as a bushing. Now, there are variations of artificial discs, but they all work on the principle of allowing motion of one of the two structures on the other structure. The problem with artificial discs is they have no shock absorption. There is no ability for the disc to absorb impact. And in addition, it doesn't have a constraint. It won't slowly move from one point to the other, but it slides uniformly. And this creates an abnormal motion on the vertebra, which I think creates more stress in the back of the vertebra and creates more problems for wear. These things also loosen over time, and they create wear debris, and the wear debris can loosen these discs, eventually needing the replacement of the disc. And if you have to go back in an area in the vena cava and aorta where you've had prior surgery, that can be quite dangerous.